the question why whose atma is because it could be somebody else's atma also. Okay. Now, so there are two different takes on it. One, either it's decided by God, some entity who is different from us, who is playing chess with us. The second point of view is where it's decided by you yourself at some different level. Personally speaking, I subscribe to the second thing, where everything is decided by you yourself at a different level. Why? Let's take an example again. You want to create a building. You want to make a building. How do you make a building? What is the first thing that you do when making a building, before making a building?
A blueprint.
A blueprint. The blueprint is based on?
Initial discussions with the architect.
Correct. And before that, you first need to have a tolerance. I have to create a blueprint. I need to create a building. So your first thought, is this clear? Your first thought that you want to create a building. Based on that, you create a blueprint. The blueprint is generally?
Well, you appoint the architect. Then you make the blueprint.
Yeah, so you appointed the architect and then you make a blueprint. The blueprint is generally in the form of an image. Okay. Based on this blueprint, now you use all your energies and the energies of all the people that you are working with, including appointing new people who would work and create those buildings. Correct? And then finally, you have the physical building in place. Is this correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, if in order to create a building, you have gone through this entire process, do you think that before taking a birth, you would have just taken a birth by chance? Just before creating a building in your real life, after you have taken birth, you go through an entire process where you actually sit and plan and analyze every situation in your life, that these are the things that I would have, these are the resources that I have, and this is the kind of building I want to create. If that is the case for a building, would you just take birth without making any plan? We are all human beings. Are you all sure we are human beings? Correct? Okay. What makes a human?
Capacity to think.
Think. Capacity to think. Okay, which means your mind. Correct? So one component of your being human is your mind. Does the mind alone make you human? No. What else? The body and the soul. Correct. So the three things which are required are
spirit.
The mind, body and soul. Or you can call it spirit, you can call it anything. Okay. The first law of thermophysics says that everything in this world is energy. Fair enough? And energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. These are the two basic laws. So which means all three of them are energy and all three of them are required to be human beings. As long as you're living, all three are there, you can see it, you can feel it, it's the energy. What happens after you die? After you die, no matter what form of ceremony you are doing after death, the body mixes one with the fire elements. Right? So whether you are lamenting somebody or giving fire, you will become one with the fire elements. These are the two elements that are still there, but you have no idea where it goes. Simple reason, all three are energy. This energy is transferred from one form to another. What does that mean? It cannot be destroyed because physics clearly says energy cannot be destroyed. The total amount of energy in the universe remains equal. Which means these two exist somewhere. Now, let's look at science. If this is your universe, science has divided this universe into two parts. One, what is known as the physics. What is physics? Everything that you can see, feel, quantify,
measure.
Basically everything to which you have a that becomes still. And everything else which exists but has no proof becomes
metaphysics.
This time is ever changing. Which means 1,000 years back, gravity was a part of metaphysics. Today it's a part of physics because there's a proof to it. 100 years back, aura was a part of metaphysics. If somebody would have gone and told you that I can see aura, people would have said, well, he is a magician who has no idea what he's talking about. Today there are cameras, there are photographs where you can click aura photographs and it's become a part of physics. Correct. So you it becomes a part of physics. So before you die, the combination of your mind, body, and soul is in physics. Right? After you die, the body comes over here, becomes one of the five elements. The mind and the soul become a part of your metaphysics. They exist, but there is no proof of how they are existing. In our understanding, based on the hypnotherapeutic cases that we have done, we have come to the conclusion that this is what we call our higher sense. The higher self is basically something which has complete information of everything that is taking place in your life. It can guide you, but it cannot overrule your freedom. Okay? It cannot overrule your choices, it cannot overrule your freedom. Which means, before you take birth, before taking birth, it's the higher self or you yourself, your mind and your soul at some other level who decide that based on the past things that I have done in my life or in my previous life, there are certain karma that I need to clear, there are certain things that I need to learn in my life. Based on that, the new life plan should be such. So the fact that you take a birth in a family, your parents are at some level chosen by you. Again, the sort of circumstances you are into in your initial life is a part of your overall planning. And that planning is done over here by you yourself before taking the birth. Now, you have taken the birth, you have come down to make a plan. Maybe you have come with a plan where there is a lot of sadness. Maybe.
There is
a lot of sadness. A lot of pain. Why would you decide, or why would you create a pain or a plan where there is a lot of pain? For a simple reason, because over here there is no body. There is no pain over here. It's only circumstances and experiences. You only feel the pain once you come down over here. So while creating a plan over here, you won't really think about the pain and the pleasure principle. You have created the plan, you come down over here. Now you realize, well, there is a lot of pain. What do? There are two things. Either you become comfortable with the pain, right? So there are so many people who have diseases which are life-threatening, but they are very poor about it. They have no problems about it. So they become comfortable. The other part is to change your life plan. Now the question is, can you change your life plan? I cannot certify this, I have no proof of this. Okay? But again, based on my understanding, based on what I have seen, what I have learned, and what I have done in my life, I would say yes. Why? Again, going back to the building example, if you have created a building, you have made the initial blueprint. In the next, and the blueprint is that you want to create a building in the next 2 years. Okay, the building should be completed in 2 years. By the end of 1 year, you realize that you are going as per the plan. They have changed. And now there are better ways and quicker ways of resolving your past karma. Or resolving whatever issues are needed to resolve. If that is the case, you can obviously change your life plan, don't you? Well, maybe what you cannot change is if you have taken a birth for some learning. This is just offshoot thought that I am having right now. Maybe if you have taken a birth for some learning, you may not change that learning. You have to take the learning. But how quickly you learn is your choice. Now, why is positive thinking important? Because every situation in your life is there, not by chance, not by coincidence, because it's there to help you with something. It's trying to tell you something. Okay? If you actually look at the situation and start worrying about it, you would never find a solution to it. There is no solution to worry. On the other hand, if you look at the solution, if you look at the problem and say, okay, what is it that I am supposed to learn from here? What is it that the universal consciousness is trying to tell me? The moment you have learned it, the purpose for that problem is over. The moment the purpose of that problem is over, the problem would solve on its own.